All glories to Sisi Guru and Gauranga. Dear Prabhu, Dandavat, know my unalloyed love and affection. Dandavat, know my unalloyed love and affection. Those Mayavadis in guise of Vaishnava dress always busy to find faults with our Guru Bharga. We must depend upon Srautapantha. We must keep strong faith in our Srautapantha. Knowingly or unknowingly, somehow, if we are going to do satsanga, then we can get result. Somehow, if we are going to do a satsanga, then we will have to suffer for that. Be careful. Brahmo pramad vipralipsa karna patav. Brahmo pramad vipralipsa karna patav. All those are the four different kinds of faults, usually not present in pure Vaishnava. So, who can say that Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is wrong? How possible that Gaur Parsha Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur can make mistake? Actually, Kali cannot allow us to do Hari Bhajan properly. Vaishnava Siddhanta can never be changed. What a pure Vaishnava can say standing on the North Pole, the same you can hear from another pure Vaishnava who is standing on the South Pole on the same topic. Maybe representation and language is different, nothing else. Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur used to say that logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. Anything we hear or read from authentic scripture, immediately we try to search an experience from our experience bank. But we forget that our material experience is totally obsolete here. Tarka apatishto sutayo vivinya naso munir jasa matam navinyam dharma satattam nihito guhayam mahayano yeno gatu sapanthya. This is an authentic slok from Mahabharata. Also from Bhagavad Gita, we can see that Sri Krishna speaking to Arjuna that bhumi rapo analo vayu khang mano buddhi revacha ahankar ityam me prakriti rastodha. Bhumi rapo analo vayu khang mano buddhi revacha ahankar ityam me prakriti rastodha. Gita 7th chapter 4th slok. Earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, reason, and also ego. Those constitute my nature divided into 8 different parts, spoken by Krishna. So our brain and mind, everything material. And prakritibhyo paru yatcha tad achinto lakshanam. Prakritibhyo paru yacha tad achinto lakshanam. It is there in our scripture, which you cannot think impossible, which is beyond human comprehension. About that we cannot apply our brain power or money power, etc. We cannot come out successful at all. Actually, without 100% submission unto the lotus feet of a tattabid sampradayik sadguru. Actually, without 100% submission unto the lotus feet of a tattabid sampradayik sadguru, Vaishna, one cannot feel perfect Siddhanta, one cannot get perfect Siddhanta. Simply by applying material mind and brain, cannot come out successful. Sri Chaitanya Prahum Mande Balopi Yadano Grahat Tare Nana Mato Graham Bapto Siddhanta Sagaram. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Nobody can cross this kind of vast infinity sagar of Siddhanta without the keeper of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Whereas in this ocean there is crocodile and shark, everything going to kill you. Tare nanamato grahyam vyaptam siddhanta sagaram. Whereas Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already told that Achinta Vedavet Tattva is beyond human comprehension, but still we cannot believe. Jivas are Nitya. Sri Krishna is also Nitya. Sri Krishna is Vibhu Chaitanya. But all Jivas are Anu Chaitanya, like atoms, molecule, Anu Chaitanya. Sri Krishna, the Supreme Lord, having the soul willpower. But those jiva, they are also having free willpower. But due to very, very smallness, infinitely small, they are very, very weak. They are so weak, that they are having every possibility of being overpowered by Maya. There is every possibility of being overpowered by Maya. Sri Krishna, the name itself implies that Sri Krishna is all attractive. But why then all jivas are not attracted by Sri Krishna? You can see a powerful magnet also sometimes cannot catch an iron piece. Not that that magnet is useless. Not that that the magnet is useless. But because a layer of ferric oxide on the iron piece acting as an insulation to prevent the iron piece to be attracted by the magnet. Similarly, all jivas are supposed to be attracted by all attractive Sri Krishna, but not all of them are seen to be attracted. Why? A layer, a screen of Maya acting as an impediment. The anadi bahirmukh Baba of jiva can stop by getting bhakti, because bhakti is the natural function of our soul, which is already there with jiva, but not yet discovered. If at all jiva can discover the pure devotional attitude, then and there can find own position in Goloka, Vrindavan. Within no time gapping. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking, those who are coming out successful in bhajan, Sarva Siddhi, Vastu Siddhi, then immediately they can go and take birth in Vrindavan. Now question is then, how possible? Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking, a infinity Brahmanda, any Brahmanda where Krishna Lila going on, then and there Krishna can, without any time gap, then they can go and take birth from the womb of a gopi, gopika. Those who are Daganuga Bhajan, those who are doing. So without any time gap, they can find their position in Goloka. That is why it is said in Chaitanya Charitamrita that Sarupe Shabar Hoy Golokete Sthiti. Sarupete Shabar Hoy Golokete Sthiti. If the actual Sarup of Jiva is discovered, they can find they are already in Goloka. When own Sarup of Jiva is discovered, then automatically they can find themselves in a nice position. I mean own position in Goloka. Jiva Nitya, Iswara Nitva, Maya Nitva, Karma is anadi nitya. So what problem in it? So what problem in it? When jiva going to get back own bhakti, which is quite natural, then can stop karma running. Bhakti is also one kind of pure karma, seva, just related to Krishna, seva. So directly or indirectly, karma is anadi, because srishti is anadi, Krishna anadi, srishti anadi, so karma is also anadi. From Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya, middle part, 2037 sloka, Krishna Vuli Shai Jeev Anadi Bahirmukh Atayev Mayatare Dei Shamsar Adi Duk. We cannot identify one specific material time of starting when jiva just forget Krishna, because anadi bahirmukh implies no starting. Forever jiva is bahirmukh. Though sarupani bhuti, though sarupanu bhuti amritamay bhakti, though sarupanu bhuti amritamay bhakti is already there in jiva, but not discovered as yet. That's why they are suffering. If we think this way, that sometime before sarupanu bhuti was there in jiva, before, if we think this way, that sometime before sarupanubhuti was there in jiva, but later on it was lost, then it is quite impossible, because after the attainment of perfect sarupanubhuti, sarupsiddhi, it can never get lost. Sarupanubhuti is also anadi. Sarupanubhuti is also anadi, but not yet felt by the anadi bahirmukh jiva. This much. So jiva is tatastha sakti of Sri Krishna, which means it is situated between spiritual and material world. Due to relative independence, free will, jiva can go either side. If jiva wants to enjoy material enjoyment in this material world, then can enter into this material world, getting false ego, you are right. Because this decision happened on tatastha plane, which is beyond material time, it is said that this conditioned jiva is anadi bahirmukha or is doing anadi karma because we cannot find any starting point within this material time period. This is also the reason for why this word anadi is used. The same you can see in jiva, the same you can see in Jaiva Dharma, chapter 15 and 16, Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving answer to this question in a very scientific way. You can find a slok in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, chapter 5:15. Nadatya kasachit papam na chaiva sakritim babhum agyaneno avritam jnanam teno muhyanti yantavaha. From this sloka, you can come to know that the omnipresent Supreme Lord God does not partake the virtue or sin of any jiva. Knowledge is enveloped with ignorance. Hence it is that jivas are constantly feeling, that jivas are constantly falling a prey to delusion or maya. Hence, it is that jivas are constantly falling a prey to delusion or maya. Supreme Lord is always impartial and indifferent. Be careful. But still, directly or indirectly, all inspiration coming from Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna, it is also true. That is why we chant Prachodayat mantra. Prachodayat mantra mean inspiration coming from Sri Krishna. Still, Sri Krishna is not at all responsible. Sri Krishna never want to arrest. Sri Krishna never want to arrest the free will of jiva. They are going to get result according to their own activities. Karma pal. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Bhatt Thakur giving a wonderful commentary on the next sloka of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, I mean chapter 5, 16 sloka. Supreme Lord never tried to put a jiva into bondage. But this is an automatic factor, procedure, according to their relative nature. Doership or enjoying mood become the cause of their bondage. And same way, detachment or peaceful attitude, etc., become the cause of their freedom. Everything is done by Supreme Lord because of His existence as a super soul everywhere, directly or indirectly. Still no partiality there with Krishna. No partial mood there with Supreme Lord Sri Krishna. He cannot have any kind of partiality or hatredness towards anybody. Now question can come that by this procedure of showing compassion, to somebody and to give punishment to somebody, whether any kind of discrimination is done by Sri Krishna, Supreme Lord, or not. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Bhatt Thakur, in his commentary on this topic, speaking that it is the duty of a mother to control a naughty boy by giving punishment, but still not at all. Lack of love and affection can be there inside the soft heart of mother. On the contrary, this can be proved to be one kind of love and affection for the children. What can be the doubt in it? Even when those asuras are killed by Hari, Krishna, then this is also one kind of compassion. Though those jivas are anadi, bahirmukh, and always busy with anadi karma, still it is not permanent. Someday it can stop. This rotation can stop by the... up and down, traveling, this rotation can stop if by chance they can meet with a pure sadhu, sadguru. That is why it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Brahmanda Barbita Kono Bhagavan Jeev, Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Beach. Brahmanda Brahmita Kono Bhagavan Jeev, Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Beach. In course of traveling around this material world for an infinity period, by chance, by the mercy of Guru Krishna, jiva can get bhakti lata bija. Bhakti is the natural function of our soul, but still all jivas are suffering. Actually, tatastha plane is also nitya anadi, where originally all jivas were there. This plane is also beyond material time. So there can be beginnings there also. The jiva can choose to either enter into spiritual world or material world. This decision is also one kind of beginning. The jiva can by own decision change position in eternity. The jiva can by own decision change position in eternity. Sri Krishna is in Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, 24th chapter, 13th sloka, Bhagavan Sri Krishna, Nandanandan Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking. In front of Nanda Baba and all other senior Brajavasis, that karmanya jayate yantu karman naivo biliyate suksham duksham bhayam khemam karman naivo vipaddati. Karmana jayate yantaha karman naivo biliyate sukham duksham bhayam khemam karman naivo avibaddati. That's mean jiva getting any specific material body according to own karma phal, and also suffering or getting enjoyment thereby automatically. Nobody is responsible. From Srimad Bhagavad Gita, also we can see that Sri Krishna speaking in front of Arjuna, Bhagavad Gita, chapter 7 and 14 sloka, Daivi jhesa gunamai mama maya duratvaya, mame boje prapadante maya metam tarantite. As per this sloka, Sri Krishna himself speaking to Arjuna, that it is next to impossible for jiva to get rid of maya. As per Vedanta Sutra nam, as per Vedanta Sutra, we can find Shakti Shakti Matur Abhed. Shakti Shakti Matur Abhed. Shakti and Shaktiman, one and the same. This is also 100% perfect Siddhanta according to Achinta Vedavet Tata. Though Sri Krishna is all attractive, still Maya, Mahamaya is also very, very attractive. So attractive that it is quite impossible for Jiva to pass away the attraction of Maya. Because those Jiva, they also always having enjoying mood like Sri Krishna. Because as per Bhagavad Gita, you can see chapter 15, 7, sloka, mamaivangso jiva luke jiva bhuta sanatanaha. Mamaivangso mean, those jiva are coming from me, just like light particle. Mamaivangso means not that the counterpart of Krishna. Mamaivangso mean, Mamaivangso doesn't mean that the counterpart of Krishna is jiva, not that. Just like light particle. I mean the Shakti Angsha. Because any counterpart of Purna Vastu, because any counterpart of Purna Vastu Krishna is also Purna Vastu. Purna Sapurna Madayo Purna Meva Avasishvate. Perhaps you have heard this sloka. So Mamaivangso means a very, very small part or particle, like particle. Okay, Shakti Ansa from Krishna. Just like very, very fine light particle. Because as per Vedanta Sutta, you can find second part of Vedanta, third chapter, 26th sloka. It is written the how we can defy, how we can describe Jivatma. To compare Jivatma with light, it is written there, light particle, it is written there in Vedanta, Jat Gunat Alokbat. Gunat Alokbat. You can go through this commentary, you can see. It is written in Vedanta Sutra that those jivatma to give description, it is written that qualitatively they are just like gunat alagbat, just like light particle. You can remember even those gopikas are also seen to be worshipping Katayani Devi, Yoga Maya Devi. Then what to speak about bonded jivas? Vedanta Sutra, chapter 2, verse 34, it is written, Lokobattu lila kaivalyam, Lokobattu lila kaivalyam. This sloka implies that the reason behind this creation is nothing but lila. This sloka implies that what is the reason behind this creation? Why Krishna taking trouble to create unnecessarily? No. It implies that the reason behind this creation is nothing but lila. The playing mood of Prabhu with jivas is one kind of infinity ras, big. With all infinity jiva. Why small boys are playing? Why small boys are playing? What can be the reason? They are beyond profit and loss mood. Simply they are going to play, to enjoy. Also, the next sutra, I mean 2.135 of that Vedanta Sutra, Vedanta, it is written, Vaishammo Nighineno Sapikshat Sapikshatvat Tathahi Darshayati. Vaishammo Nirghanyeno Sapikshatvat Tathahi Darshayati. It implies that apparently it seems that Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, is not at all impartial. But actually not that. Why so? Just next sloka of this Vedanta Sutra is speaking, 2.136 number, Vedanta Sutra. Na karma vibhaga diti chet nanatitvat, nanaditvat. Na karma vibhaga, na karma vibhaga diti chet nanaditvat. It implies when nothing was there, if you say, when nothing was there, then at that starting point, where from karma came? Whereas you are speaking karma is anadi. When nothing was there, no srishti was there, then at that time, I am starting pure, where from karma came? From Srimad Bhagavad Gita, from Srimad Bhagavatam, not Bhagavad Gita, from Srimad Bhagavatam, 3.26.20 number sloka, third canto, 26 chapter, 20 sloka, 20 number sloka, we can see that Vishwamatma Gatam Vyanjano Kutastho Jagadam Kuraha. Vishwamatma Gatam Vyanjano Kutastho Jagadam Kuraha. Number 26, 20th sloka, 26th chapter, 3rd canto. Vishwatmagatam Banjana Kutastho Jagadam Kuraha. This implies that flow of creation is anadi nitya. So karma of jiva is also anadi, and discrimination thereby also anadi. So whom to blame? Any kind of discrimination mood, we cannot expect there with the Creator, Sri Krishna. Only playing mood is there with Parabrahma. Because countless jivas getting countless type of rank and position and situation. In Brihad Aranyak Upanishad, we can see one sloka to get exact solution of this question. It is written there in the sloka, Sadhu Kari Sadhu Bhavati Papa Kari Papo Bhavati Pujyaha Pujyena Karamana Bhavati. This implies that according to different karmapal, they are going to get different results. Whom to be blamed? Now question is that, if karma is responsible, then before creation there was no karma. Then where from karma came? But from Chaitanya Charitamrita we already know it is there, the karma is anadi. Then what is the solution? Another sloka from Vedanta, same chapter, I mean 2.138 number sloka from Vedanta can give exact solution. It is written there, the sutra is that, Sarvo dharmo papattischa, Sarvo dharmo papattischa. How it is possible to get all proper adjustment of two completely separate and contradictory subject matter. It is written there in Vedanta, the sarvo dharmopapattischa. How it is possible to get all proper adjustment of two completely separate and contradictory subject matters? This sloka implies that any different kind of contradictory matters can get adjusted, can get harmonized properly in Brahma, in Parabrahma. In the sloka, all dharmas means, in the sloka, all dharmas, it means action dharma or just reverse dharma or any favorable dharma can get all proper adjustment in Parabrahma. This is the ultimate solution. Srila Baladev Vidyavasan Prabhu in his commentary on Vedanta Sutra 2336 sloka, 2336 sloka from Vedanta, you can find Prithog Upadeshat. Prithog Upadeshat. In this sloka, Vishwanath Chakravarti Baladev Vidyavasan Prabhu speaking, that jnana of jiva is nitya. I mean, itself there in jiva, but not yet manifested as yet. Satchit and anandamai hari, satchit anandamai hari is there with his soul will power. But remember, jivas are also amsa, sakti mamsa, light particle, just like light particle coming from Sri Krishna, Krishna sakti. So we should remember also those jivas, they are also having some same quality, satchid ananda, but very very small. From 2324 sloka of Vedanta, we can see that guna dalakbad, I already told you. Yes, just like light particle, they have the same quality because they are coming from Krishna, same quality, qualitatively all same, but very very weak, very very weak, infinitesimal part of Shakti. So from 2324 sloka of Vedanta, we can see that the Jivatma, just like light particle, Gunat Alagbat, I already told you. Why Jnana is not manifested in Jiva? Now question can come, why Jnana is not manifested in Jiva, whereas it is already there with Jiva? From Bhagavad Gita sloka 5.14, I already told, Nadatte kasachit papam na chaiva sukritim vibhum ajnaneno avritam jnanam tena mujhyanti yantabaha. Due to averse fullness, jivas become covered up by avidya or maya. When jivatma turned off to the Lord, then and there, that jnana can get manifested. Because jnana is also anadi, it is already there with jiva. Just like mud and clay and dust, just like mud, clay and dust can cover up the self-manifesting light or brightness of a jewel, money, like diamond. As soon as it is cleaned up, then automatically sparklings can stir. So the above Siddhanta we have received from Srila Baladev Vidyavasan Prabhu, the same spoken by Srila Vishwanath Chakrabartibad in his commentary of this sloka, I mean Srimad Bhagavatam 11 canto, second part, 37 sloka, commentary by Vishwanath Chakrabartibad. The sloka of Srimad Bhagavatam, it speaks, it is written there, Bhayam ditiya vinivesatah swat ishat apatascha viparaya sruti tanmayaya to budh avayatvam vaktaika esham gurudev tatma. Here in this sloka, ishat apatascha means turning away from Supreme Lord. This become the cause of coming under the influence of Mahamaya. The same spoken by Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna bully say jiv anadi bahirmukh atayab maya tare dait sansharadi duk. So because Baladev Vidyavasan Prabhu mentioned both points, so now we have to find out proper reconciliation. Actually, if you think very minutely, anadi, I mean infinity plus infinity is equal to infinity. Infinity, I mean anadi minus anadi is also anadi. From Brahma Samhita, we can see the Ishwaraha Paramakrishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam. If Sri Govinda is the Adi Karan, then how possible that Mahavishnu is also Adi? Who is first? Who is second? This kind of conception is also related to material time conception. Who is first? Who is second? This kind of conception is also related to material time conception. Both anadi karan, but still Sri Govinda is anadi radi, original source of all causes. About eternal conception, there should not be any finite conception should be there. Gokul lila, Goloka lila is eternal. Mahavishnu Srishti lila is also eternal. If we try to reject the possibility of jiva, if we can reject the possibility of any choice of jiva, if we reject the possibility of having any choice on the part of jiva, if we say there is no existing or no question of any choice, if we can reject this possibility, the jivas, they don't have any choice, no possibility. Previous to bondage of jiva, then simply because bondage is anadi, if we speak this way, then again a finite conception growing. If we reject the possibility on the part of jiva that there cannot be any option, the jiva can take any decision as existing there with jiva, previous to bondage stage of jiva, simply because bondage is anadi, then again a finite conception growing, which is totally obsolete. Also, if jiva's free will power to choose something of his own is gone, then jiva become equal to a matter. This is also not possible. Follow what I say. Also, if jiva's free will If jiva's free will for to choose something of his own is gone, then jiva become equal to a matter, inert object, which is not possible. Why insects want to enter into fire, being attracted by the glowing, charming light to die? Why insects want to enter into the glowing fire, being attracted by the glowing, charming light? Why? To die? How? Knowingly or unknowingly? How? If you say that knowingly, then question can come. Who like to die knowingly? Or if you say unknowingly, then also one question can come. Then where is the consciousness, willpower? Where is the free willpower? Willpower jiva gone somewhere? Then where the consciousness of jiva gone? Where is the will, free willpower is gone somewhere? How possible that unknowingly that those insects, I mean jivas, jumping into fire? Then what is the solution? Solution is that actually consciousness and free will power is there, but still they become undone. They become undone. They become hypnotized, just like magic spell. By the magic spell of Maya, they become undone, overwhelmed by Maya. Similarly, though jivas, similarly, though those jivas, bonded jivas, are running with consciousness and willpower, but still they become just overwhelmed by the magic spell of Maya to jump into material enjoyment. So there is no scope at all for us to think separate way. So there is no scope at all for us to think separate way. All proper adjustment of any contradictory point can get balanced in Parabrahma Sri Krishna. So we need not play our teeny brain over this matter. From the commentary of Srimad Bhagavatam 4.22.32 sloka, 4th canto 22 chapter 32 sloka, from the commentary of Srimad Bhagavatam by this sloka, by Srimad Viswana Chakrotipa, what is the sloka? Natoho parataro loke pungsaha swartho vyatikramaha yadadhyanyasya preyahastamatmanaha swabhyatikramat. Srimad Bhagavatam, 4th canto 22, chapter 32 sloka. Natoho parataro loke pungsaha swartho vyatikramaha jadadhyanyasya preyastamatmanaha sabhyatikramat. We can see from this sloka that jiva's bondage is spontaneous, but not without any reason. Reason is there, secret reason. What then the cause is, reason is, Sachid Anandamay Hari Vibhu Chaitanya Vastu, but those jivas, Anu Chaitanya, very, very small, very, very weak. So, usually, they cannot stand in front of Maya. This is the reason for why they fall down in Maya. From Gita, we can find that Sri Krishna speaking in front of Arjuna, Daivi jesa gunamai mama maya duratvaya mameva prapadante maya metam tarantithi. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, 7th chapter, 14th sloka. 4th sloka. 4. Sri Krishna is all attractive, no doubt in it, but still, Maya is also not less attractive, even more. We would say, because Sri Krishna speaking, Maya, Mama Maya, Duratvaya, Duratukramaniya, Mama Maya, Duratukramaniya, Duratvaya, mean you cannot cross this Maya, you cannot cut Mama Maya. Also, you know it from, you know it very well, that how Kamjoyi, you know it very well from Bhagavatam, that how Kamjoyi Swankar Bhagavan was running after Mohini. You know it very well, that how it was possible for Shankar Kamjoyi, who already got victory over Kama, Krodha, everything. But how it was possible for Kamjoyi Shankar Krishna to run after Mohini Maya? So powerful Krishna's Maya. What to speak more? We know that Sri Krishna is all attractive Madan Mohan. But still, we know that Sri Krishna is also attracted by Srimati Radharani. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can find one sloka, nice sloka, that Krishna is attracted. Krishna himself in Madan Mohan. When Radharani is not there, then Madan Mohan, this name is not perfect. Also from Upanishad you can find one sloka, Atma va are drashtabhyo sratabhyo nididhashitabhyo. According to this evidence, you can find that everything is meaningful because all pervading Atma, Paramatma is there. Everything is meaningful because Paramatma is there. Who is sitting inside everybody? Srila Chakravarti Thakur also speaking that due to the presence of Atma, everything become meaningful. Otherwise, all useless. With relation to Atma, everything become related, meaningful. Also, I already told you, know this sloka from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 5:14. Nādatte kasachit papam na chaiva sakritim vibhum agyanena avritam jnanam tenam uyanti yandava. From Bhagavad Gita, chapter 9, 4 to 6, 4, 5 and 6, 3 slokas, you can find the meaning, we can get total information about Achinta Vedavat Tatta. It is written there. And on 7th sloka, I mean same chapter, 9th chapter, 7th sloka, you can find that it is written, Sarva Bhutani Kantiyo Prakatim Janti Mamakam Kalpo Khaye punastvani kalpadu visrijyami aham. And those sloka, previous I quote, I mean, 9th chapter, 4th sloka, it is there. Maya tatamidam sarvam jagat abhyakta murtina matstani sarvabhutani na chaham teshu avasthita. Next sloka, I mean number 5 sloka. Na cha matstani bhutani pasame yogo maishwaram bhuta bhrit cha bhutasto mamatma bhuta bhavanah. Then next sloka again. Yatha akasa sthita nityam bayu sarvotrogo mahano tatha sarvani bhutani matstani yuti upadharayo. You can consult those sloka. And the last sloka, abhid sarva bhutani kantiyo prakatim yanti mamakam kalpakhaye punastvani kalpadu srijami aham. From this sloka we can get total information about. From this sloka we can get the total information about the whereabout of all jivas after total destruction of srishti. Jnana of jiva is already there with jiva for an infinity period, anadi. But the attachment with avidya due to maya, putting jiva in trouble. But the attachment with avidya, putting jiva, all jivas in trouble. So we can see from Chaitanya Charitamrita the following. Krishna boli se jiva anadi bahirmukha te mayata dek sansara didu. Also we can see another sloka from Chaitanya Charitamrita that Brahmanda Vrmita Kuna Bhagavan Jeev Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Beach. Srila Vishwanath Chakradivar Thakur also speaking the same, that in course of travelling around this material Brahmanda, by chance, by the causeless mercy of Sadguru Vaishnava, Ajiva can get Bhakti Lata Bija and can stop traveling. In this material world, cause and effect both having some material time gapping. Remember, in this material world, cause and effect both having some material time gapping with each other, but in Nitya Jagat, there is no such time gapping. Because the name of any object or any person or any incident, I mean sequence, there is just equal to the object it means. Identical. That is why we can say Nitya Vartaman, always present tense, present continuous. We can say Nitya Vartaman is there. Time conception there you cannot realize because you are here in this material world. The great scientist Einstein was asked, "Sir, what do you mean by time?" Einstein was bound to answer that time is nothing but movement. Einstein told the time, the great scientist Einstein told, the time is nothing but movement. This is the basic fundamental, idea of the theory of relativity. Really, time is nothing but movement. Then the next question coming, who or what will move? Or how far? How long? Then it is seen that automatically time, space and matters all are interrelated factors on this material platform. But there, on that transcendental plane, not like that. Their time, space and matter, each of those factors are always ready to contribute voluntarily in favor of Lila Vilas of Prabhu. All those are automatically positively arranged. All those factors are automatically positively arranged by Yogamaya. Sometimes if negative is also necessary, then can Yogamaya can do accordingly. As for example, Srimati Radharani, together with all her sakhis, like to go to Kusum Sarovar to collect flowers to worship Surya Narayan Bhagavan, Surya Puja, you know. Then from Kusum Sarovar again, coming back to Radha Kunda, then again from Radha Kunda going to Surya Kunda, from Surya Kunda again coming to Radha Kunda. How possible to cover such a long distance within this short period of time? Can you give answer? This kind of material conception is totally obsolete there. Everything is arranged positively by Yogamaya in favor of Lila Vilas. So they need not play their head about time factor or distance factor, etc. This way, somehow I am giving answer. If you can come in front of me, I can discuss all in details. I am very, very happy that you are putting this kind of question. Though I have no time, but still I am bound to give answer. And actually, you are giving also some reconciliation to that sannyasis, where you say that when some Bada Jiva becomes Sadhan Siddha, then she will enter into eternal Golokadam. So although Goloka is eternal and above material time, still there are certain beginnings there. As with this entrance of Sadhan Siddha Jiva. So if Jiva can have her beginning of Seva in Goloka Dhamma, like we see in the description of Gopa Kumar in Brihad Bhagavatam Mitra, written by Sri Sanatana Goswami Pada, then we cannot say there cannot be any beginning in eternity, above material time. So tatastha plane is also above material time, so there can be beginning there also. The jiva can choose to enter into spiritual world, the material world. The decision, one kind of study. I already give answer. You can go through my answer very carefully and try to get your exact answer. And what to speak more? Please excuse me. I like to stop now. Vancha kalpadruvasi ke pasindhi bhavishya patitanang pavana bhavishya bhyo namo namo.